So that was the end of it, as far as I was concerned. And we left. A few weeks later, I remember I was flying out to Minneapolis, Minnesota, and the planes that leave the airport nearby bank over in this direction towards this farm as you're flying out of Ithaca Airport. And all of a sudden was impressed with the fact that that farm was down there and I should go see it when I came back from my trip. So I did so, reluctantly, but I came back and wandered through the barn. And as I did, I began to see something I hadn't seen before. It was as if the Lord in the Spirit was projecting me into a movie that was taking place in the future. And I felt like I was walking through, you know, this situation. And as I wandered around the barn, I saw things transformed in front of my eyes. The old garbage room with garbage cans all of a sudden turned into a bookshop. Small hallway, I could see posters in it, leading into a large room where the hay was stored, which would become a theater, and then looking up in the hayloft would become a balcony, and people would be sitting up there. I saw a theater in the round with different stages, and a large window would be over in this wall over here, and then looking up the silo, a dome on top of it, downstairs in the cow stalls where the cows were and ponies were, I could see those as booths or tables for people to sit in a coffee shop. And it went on like that. And that was really a vision, a very real vision. Now, it may have stayed that way, just a vision. But after that, the Lord began to impress upon me to come out here and begin working and to begin to transform this barn from what I'd seen, from what I was seeing to what he was seeing. From what it was as a cow barn to a people barn.
Are going to be in order when the world system family people are going to be falling to pieces. The whole family structure is just disassembling in the world. Oh, you don't have to get married, just hang out. We were downtown last night and we were talking about this, and one of our men here is a mailman. And he delivers the mail up through College Town, and he says it's the most difficult route in Ithaca because all throughout College Town, you take a letter to Jane Smith at 25 Jones Street, and you say, here's a letter for Jane Smith. Oh, she's not living here anymore. She moved up with the guy up on, up the block. She's moving up there now. So he takes the letter up there, and he says, here's Jane Smith's letter. Oh, thank you very much. Next week, comes back, and a letter to Jane Smith. Goes up to that address. Here's a letter for Jane Smith. Oh, she's moved. She's living with a guy down there. Oh, and everybody's living with everybody. No, I mean, I'm not shocked by that. I just know that it's happening, and I know it's sin, and I know those people need to see an example. We have a lot of those people come out here saying, why, you mean you guys, oh, come on, man, you mean you guys don't sleep around? No. A lot of people are surprised, a lot of Christians are surprised by that. No, we don't. Oh, come on, man, you got a little, huh? Huh? Yeah, you go out and your wife every once in a while. No? Oh, you're weird. I'm weird. I don't got my wife. I'm weird. You know? My children know me and recognize me.
Oh.
as Lord in your hearts. Period. Set him aside. Sanctify Jesus in your heart as Lord. Christ as Lord in your hearts. People, then the world will know is by our fruits. Then the world will know he's been sent. Then the world will know that we love one another and that we love the Lord first. Jesus is Lord. Praise God. Hallelujah. God, Lord, 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 Lord. Praise you, Lord. Jesus, you are Lord.
Thank you, Lord. Praise you, God.
Praise you, God. You are the Lord. You have risen from the dead, and you are Lord. And every knee will bow, and every tongue is going to confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. They're going to confess it. They're going to have to. But, Lord, I'm doing it now, Lord. I confess your Lordship in my life.
Open to whatever the Lord wants for my life to be used in whatever way, even with the singing. I've been singing more lately publicly. I guess I went through so many changes about the old me that I didn't want any of the old me standing up there doing my thing, that whatever I did, I wanted to be for Christ. I feel that as a disciple of his, I've got the world ahead of me, you know, and trying to be open that if the Lord wants me someplace to be used, you know, just to be open, if he wants to take us someplace else to do what we've done here, then fine, you know, I'm open to it. I guess I've been used basically now with just being a witness of what Christ can do to a life and all the good things he's given me. You know, so many beautiful things
my
to
life
show
and my soul to you. Show me, Lord, how to live the way that you want me to.
That, friends, is my wife, Nedra, doing an imitation of a thunderclap. On the Scott Ross program, going back in time a few years, remember about 1964, the Ronettes walking in the rain? Well, Nedra used to walk in the rain, now she walks in the light of the Son of God.
I want him.